Hi, today's lesson is going to be on optimizing revenue functions. Our example today involves a demand for cat food given by the function d of x equals 190e to the negative 0.04x. X is the number of units sold, and d of x is the price. So they want three things. They want to find the revenue function, find the number of units sold that will maximize the revenue, and find the price that will yield the maximum revenue. So first of all, I think identifying the variables and just making sure we understand what the variables are would be a good start. So starting with what X represents. So in this problem, X is the number of units sold. And in this case, we're talking about units of cat food. And the d of x, they identify as the price in dollars. So that when we make our revenue function, because we know that revenue is quantity multiplied by price, that we know what functions to use. So the first part, finding the revenue function, will be R of x is going to be the quantity, which we identified as x, multiplied by the price, which is given in the problem, 190e to the negative 0.04x. So when we combine those together, there's not a lot to do, but we could multiply the x and the 190. So we'll have 190x e to the negative 0.04x. So this will be our revenue function. All right. So this is the answer to part A. The next thing they want to know is find the number of units sold that will maximize the revenue. So if you want to maximize the revenue, you start with taking your revenue function, finding the critical point, identifying if that critical point's a minimum or a maximum, and then going from there. So we're going to start with finding the critical point, which means we have to get the derivative of the revenue. Now this revenue function is the product of two functions. So think of it as an f of x times a g of x. So we're going to have to use the product rule to get the derivative. So if you recall, the product rule, at least the way I remember it, is f prime times g of x plus g prime of x times f of x. Okay, so for our function, here goes. The derivative of the revenue is going to be the derivative of f of x, so the derivative of 190x is just 190, multiplied by g of x, which is e to the negative 0.04x, plus the derivative of g of x, so the derivative of e is just the same function, e to the negative 0.04x. However, don't forget the chain rule, multiplied by the derivative of the inside, so times by negative 0.04. And then times that by f of x, which is 190x. Okay, so this is our product rule. So again, the 190 is the f prime. This is the g. This all right here is g prime. And this is your f. Okay, so simplifying that and factoring that. So the derivative, we're going to factor this because our next step is going to be setting it equal to 0 to find the critical points. So let me factor out. We have two terms here. So each term has a 190. So I'm going to take out a 190. And each term has the e to the negative 0.04x. So I'm going to factor that out of each term. So what's going to be left for the first term, and again, when I say the first term, I mean this term here. This is our first term, and this whole thing, that's our second term. So after I take that out from the first term, I just end up with 1 plus, when I take out the 190 and the e to the negative 0.4x, what I'm left with is a negative 0.04 and the x. Okay, so then I'm going to set this equal to 0 to find the critical points, because critical points are always where the derivative is equal to 0 or where the derivative is undefined. In this case, I don't see any place where our derivative is undefined. So I have it factored, so I'm going to set each factor equal to 0 and solve for the x. So setting these each equal to 0, solving for x. Now here on this first one, when we solve for x, if I divide by 190 on both sides, then I'm going to get this e to the negative 0.04x equals 0. And that's just not possible. You can't have e to an exponent equaling 0. If you want to keep going, you could try taking the natural log of both sides, but when you take the natural log of 0, that's undefined. So this is not going to give us any solution. This is not going to find us an x value or a critical point. This other one, however, will. So if I move my 0.04x to the other side and then solve this, I'm going to have 1 equals 0.04x. And then if you divide both sides by 0.04x, you're going to end up with a nice number, x equals 25. So this is our critical point. And it's our only critical point. So now what we have to do with this critical value is figure out, is this the max or is this the minimum for the function? So there's two ways. We could do a second derivative test, which I think the second derivative on this would be, again, a complicated product rule. So I think it might be easier just to do a first derivative test on this. In other words, put our 25 on the number line and pick values on each side of 25 to plug into the first derivative. And then that will tell us if it's increasing or decreasing. So for example, I could pick, say, x is 1 on this side, and maybe over here on this side, you know, x is, say, 26. And what we do is we plug them into the first derivative. Now, that still is going to take a little bit of work. You know, you're going to need your calculator to do that. So if you take 1 and plug that into your first derivative, and be careful typing that in, what you'll find is that, and again, we don't care what number we get, we just want to know, is it positive or negative? So what you're going to end up here is you're going to find out that you get a positive value. And that means our derivative is positive. And when the derivative is positive, it means your function is increasing. Now, if we do same kind of thing, take our 26 and plug it into our derivative. And again, we don't care the number we get. We just want to know, do we get a positive or do we get a negative value? And carefully typing that in your calculator, you're going to see you get a negative value, which means if your derivative is negative, that your function's decreasing. So what this means is if your function's going up and then coming back down, that at 25, that we have a maximum. Okay, so the revenue is a max when x is 25. Now, I believe that was the second question. Let me scroll back up here to the actual question that we have. So it says, find the number of units sold that will maximize the revenue. Okay, so that's going to be the answer to the second part. So what we're going to do is we're going to answer that. We're going to sell 25 units of cat food to maximize the revenue. Okay, so we got 2 out of 3 done. So the last question was determining the price. Now we have a equation that gives us the price. So if we want to find the price, that's what we're going to use, is that equation. And remember, the price was d of x. So we're going to need to take our x value of 25 and plug it in the price function. So what we need to do is find d of 25. So we're going to plug that into our demand function. Okay, so way back up here, let me go get that demand function again. That was from our original. Remember we set down the price was 190e to the negative 0.04x. So it's going to be 190e negative 0.04 times x, which x is 25. So typing this in the calculator and remembering that this is going to be money, so we're going to round off to two decimal places. So what we end up getting here is 69.897, etc. And again, since this is money, we're going to say this is $69 and rounding to two decimal places, 90 cents. So this is going to be the price where the revenue is the maximum. So I'm guessing these are probably cases of cat food. So price of $69.90 will max your revenue. All right, so there we've answered all three questions, and I hope this has been helpful.